Okay, so today I was looking towards doing the data importers, trying to just collect all of the, in this case, distributed YAML importers together in one set, much like with ECS groups, I believe. That was the idea anyways. And what I'm probably going to do, actually, is... Do I want to do that, actually? That may be better. Yeah. Okay. I'm thinking of moving groups out. I want to make kind of like a thing... A set, so much like an array currently of index generators, it'll be an index array of the index generators and like the importers for most groups and that, and it'll be combined into one class. So one, if I'm going to accomplish that, first things first, I'm going to have to move that down a little bit. So this is foeID stuff, and then we'll have... We'll probably just have something down. Nope. Groups. We'll just make this like a top level enum or something like that. Like that, right? Something like that. It'll be like foe persistent group. And what I can probably do is move these guys down into that. ID group, ID type. We'll have another enum that sits down here. We'll kind of split them up a little bit. Valid type bits. Like that. Something like this. Okay, no, this is a generic UN32 type deal. I'll work with that. Group bits, group value. Okay, and I probably want to get rid of the ECS prefixes as well. It's not really... So that's probably something closer to this, like foeID toString or something like that. Okay, one thing we're going to want to do, though, is... Okay, actually... Am I building tests? No. Okay, good. You're right about that. It doesn't exist anymore. Foe temporary group. What else am I missing? Is it this? Oh, because of that. YAML write ID for a persistent group. So it doesn't need groups, it just needs ID, right? Hold on. Why? Oh, let me guess. There's been an update to Vulkan, right? Vulkan. Core version 174. And I think I want to go up to 173. So actually, no, I did this in another system, didn't I? Yeah, where I pulled that. So git. That should bring out 174 version, right? Rebuild. TikTok, come on. Okay. Okay. Well, while that's going on, temporary or persistent. So that should mean we have groups. ID. Wow, this is like everything is down. Yeah, okay. Nothing's happening anywhere, apparently. You know what? I should have just done this in the first place. Yes. Foe persistent. Okay. Amazing. Okay. This, that. Okay. Okay, so that gets moved out. We change those. Let's close that up. Yes. General ID. These things are all moved around a little bit. Move that because we don't need it. Mm-hmm. The tests, that makes sense. We also need to do this. It's a long way to temporary. Close. Back to this. Just make sure it does. Make while I'm continuing on with the rest of these. Okay, so that's one part. What I want to do now is actually like rename these, get rid of the ECS and stuff, so that it becomes like foeID valid index bits or something like that. Instead of foeECs, because the ECS, I mean, it's not really part of the entity component system. It's just an ID system. The ID system will be integrated into it. The IDs are fundamentally separate. Yeah, we got some issues with that. Thing I did that. We'll do the opposite as well. foeID invalid. Both ways. May want to change these to be like functions to look outside, perhaps. Group value. Okay, one thing I probably want to do though is that's the bit flag. ID. Equals this. Yeah, which has to be first. So we can shift it by that, and we shift it by that. We do the same thing down here. Just one, zero or one in this case. Is this right? Yes, this would be right. You shift it over, so you have a full set of ones. You shift it over by that many times. You shift it back by four, seven? Hold on. No. Okay, this is actually does. Do 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 do. Num index bits, num those bits. Yeah, that goes that way. This doesn't shift at all, so that's fine. We leave it like that. Okay, just make a test. Pause it while that runs for half a minute, or actually even less than that. 2.5 seconds. Okay. Okay, let's see what we can do about. Okay, let's see all cases of this. Okay, we'll actually just do one thing at a time. This. Does it need groups anymore? Yes. ECS get group ID. Does this require groups? And the answer is no. This is only this is always the issue with updating a header. A lot of items. Okay, we got that. Now we do the ECS to foeID thing. We will start with the index generator. Whoa, yeah, that's very wrong. That's very wrong indeed. That should be like the foeID valid type bits. Okay, replace preview, whatever. Index, obviously that's something I didn't actually start testing on index generator, is it? Plain reset, reset initial values. Zero F. How many bits do we set for that? Four. So that's an F, yeah. That makes sense. Then what I need is to as an entity. And then this one will be generate resource. So it's F, V8. No, F8. Acquire is entity test 0. Well, interesting. It's 0F. It should be generating a resource. Maybe I do have the wrong. Actually, that doesn't even matter. If it's foe valid in ID, then it's. The test, let's change it up for the foeEc. Oh, it still is that test. Nice. Oh, the group. Yes, the group. Yeah, no, that type makes perfect sense. Actually, now that I think about it. The group is still 0F. /198. When I free it, it should only be the index ID. So why is it? Is it like, is this not retry? Is this not okay. We go in. We got the ID, which is 4 whatever. Oh. Okay. Ooh, yeah, I can't do that. Okay, now it makes sense. Okay. What if, okay, I need to like do a reversal almost of this stuff. So this one will be, and then we do this one as a resource. It's an entity ID. As a resource. Nope, not quite. Test one. Oh. Nope, still down. Is resource. Variable. Okay, we got all that. Now that was with index with group ID of 0f. Now we're going to do the same thing on the other one, which starts at group 0. Nope, not here. Wait, I'm... What? Did I change the F0? Did I literally have it running 2 times? Whoops. Okay, let's just put that up. It's fixed, whatever. What was it? That needs to be changed as well. Foegroup bit shift. Can I just open the file? Groups test. Or rather, the function, which is foeECs, normalized to group ID. Back to this one again. They're all internal to here. We'll do it. max custom groups. Dynamic groups. Okay, now we get to the function names, which we want to do like no, just do it. Normalized. Crap. That didn't work out. I screwed that one up real bad. Okay, we'll just have to redo them all. Do that. We're going to move that to this one. Okay, just a few more to go. Value to group. foeID. Nope, I screwed that up. Yikes. Normalized. Group to value. That value to group and group to value. ID is resource, is that belongs to type. Index. Sure, these are good. Okay. I really need to add some tests for like these functions and stuff. I really do. And I need to expand the functions here as well eventually, but Right. Realistic. Up string stream C standard in, yeah. This might realistically be something I want to put in a, so I can slightly lighten down on these. Just really this and this really. Yeah. Leave it. Okay, now with all that out of the way, for the moment, realistically what I wanted to do was move the group stuff down. Now, I'm not going to change groups as it is quite yet. I'm pretty sure I use this in a couple locations. Yeah. So I'll have something new down here that'll be like group data. Group data, group info. Something that's specific to groups. Figuring it'll be very similar to this, so you'll have something that'll be close to what? Just call it like a find group. Of that or a struct. Just take a foeID index generator. Do I actually do anything here? Not really. I just kind of have pointers, so P and IC, something like that. We have a combined group for here. Just an index group. Just an index generator for. Actually, no. These the combined, okay, the impersistent indices will be here. Then we'll have a foeImporter base. If it has it. And then mTemporary indices. And then we have the standard array of the combined group. Like that. Very similar, but all the way down here instead. Do I want unique pointers? Maybe. I mean, I have this. I mean, this is defined. This is also defined. That's. If I'm not doing a pointer and I'm having these in line, then I already have the definition, so I can do a unique pointer. In fact, we don't even need names for these anymore, actually. It'd just be like the just that. Basically the same thing, except we're just doing with the importer. Okay, we don't actually need this here. Yes, we do for the unique pointer. I really don't like. I mean, it's nice to have the memory safety of the unique of smart pointers, but the fact that everything needs to be fully defined for them is really annoying. Like, really annoying. Okay, these functions like that. Let's actually change it up to the auto. Do that instead. One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10. Okay. Is there any reason to remove dynamic group? No, there is not. You can just generate a new set of group, new group data, realistically. Group, then we got auto. Just make sure it's correct. Otherwise, we need to go through. Value of group. This is interesting. Okay, no. Nope, get rid of the consts. Bad idea. Null pointer for that one. So very similar, kind of. Same thing on the string side. Persistent importer. Return that. Need to add this group data. Nope, we got one that, yes, adding still isn't done. So much like this, back in the day, we go through the normalized group. Okay, group data, have a couple const expressions. This is only returning it for pointers anyways. So there's no real point in having it embedded, is there? Okay, what, No. greater or equal to max dynamic groups. Actually, that's a bit of an issue. I don't know. The ID group it's going to be until I've already added it in. Unless I go back to the idea of having, like, it could be anything in the range. Maybe. Gotta check through duplicate names, which means what? First of all, P importer. Temporary name. Turn false. Not within the valid range of. Then we just got to go through and for and iterator of m dynamic groups. Check that the group used Now we go through for launch time iterator, dynamic groups. We could check through all of them. If that's the case, otherwise, and dynamic groups, group value. May actually want to change this to like return a standard error code instead of this. Realistically. But not quite yet, not right now. Groups, I think I got all the stuff. I want to add tests for this because I want to be able to delete groups. I want to confirm that this works how I think it does. So I need to have a look at the base application, see how, is this built as like a full executable or it's like a library that it's linked in. Foe engine, I am GUI. It goes into source, which goes into this. Okay, I want to change up the how this works then real quick. Once I need to pause this for a moment. Okay, what I want to do is I'm going to change up. Let's close that up. Close others. I want to change this from like an executable to like something like this with a much. Okay, foe engine. Like that. And then I'm going to have a library. this. foeEngine lib. foeEngine lib. Okay, I need this. I need a target link libraries. Just foeEngine. It's like that. And foeEngine that. Move this stuff around just a little bit. Mm-hmm. And then we go into the subdirectory and we have sources foeEngine, which is just private, and just has main.cpp. Everything else goes into foeEngine lib, including the XR, including the items down here. Nothing in there, nothing in there. That's already separate. This is missing from, for some reason, private. It's including it. So this stuff, oh, public. Main, oh, main and application. Whoops. What I want to do is, okay, it doesn't really matter which way I do it, does it? Okay, what I need to do is change, when I get down to here, visible, no longer hidden in lines. Default. Protected and internal. Okay, that seems to be okay. Oh, yeah. Back to that. Run that. Run the full application now. Uh-huh. Okay. Then I can start adding a test thing for the main application. So I can actually build up tests for this before I move them out to their own separate libraries later. Because that's kind of one of the issues I keep running into, is I keep moving things to libraries before they're really fully cooked. Running into an issue where it's kind of improperly scoped or improperly placed beforehand. Then it becomes a bit harder to move it back out to where it should be. So test. Get an example from here. That's also been why I've not really been adding tests to a lot of this stuff either. It just hasn't really. It's just been something I don't want to move a lot of these things out yet. Takes like 2 seconds, right? 2-3 seconds, ba-bam. All right, groups, something similar to this. One thing I want to do is target include directories. Goes in the source. So we include group data. Not for everything, just the file. Something like that. I'm sorry, what? What did I do? Okay. I don't remember doing anything to do with what this is. and exist test. Okay. But it doesn't exist. So hold on. Where's Chrome? Okay, CMake exists. Like, I thought that was the checks the file system, right? If yeah, it's a file operation. Why is it somebody complaining about this? Did they break these or something? Like, I. Well, that doesn't make any sense. It doesn't even reach the compilation stage, just configuration stage. Make export compile commands equals one and we dash d equals on. E dash, thank you. What? No idea. Okay, we're up here again. We have it, we're building in. It's great. Okay, so we got persistent. We do include this, right? Yeah, do build tests. Okay, maybe I just need to reopen the file. Okay, maybe I just need to reopen VS Code and then it'll catch on to the new compile commands, right? Test. Nope, it's not adding that. Why? What is going on? Okay, I guess we'll just do that. Okay, we gotta do this. Add it to all these other locations. Okay, not this. Save that. Another. Okay, group data. Back down here. Indices, da 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 da. There's no invalid group technically. Oh, it just goes to max, so there's no invalid, yeah. Okay, we've done that. We've added the groups. I need a dummy importer base, don't I? Okay, you know. That's actually a good. The entire point of all of this was to be able to get resources easily. So I should actually add that before I finish this up. So the idea was getting a resource. Something like, what does it look like in here? Get resource, not even here. I also need to, no, the translation's part of the importer. Something like this. Okay, then what I need to do is, I need to add this to the importer base, first of all. Then we go back to group data, source, down at the bottom. That, then we try. Otherwise, for auto const, and we gotta go through them, and dynamic groups, and we gotta move backwards. Actually, no, we need to move backwards. equals in dynamic groups dot r begin. Not equals in dynamic groups dot r end. How? Oh, return type. And the rest of this is all for the test stuff. So what that is basically what I wanted to accomplish. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go offline because I'm going to do the tests. I'm going to generate the test, which is going to be super boring. No one wants to see that. So I'll do that and come back with something interesting tomorrow. Cheers.